Another charge that is often leveled at Islam is that it was spread violently by the sword. This allegation is completely unfounded, and indeed nothing could be further from the truth. All of the wars fought during the life of the Holy Prophet, peace and blessing of Allah be upon him, and the four rightly guided caliphs who succeeded him were entirely defensive in nature, where war had been forced upon them. And even where war had been forced upon them, upon the Muslims, they still sought to protect and respect the revered places of other religions and their respected figures.
فارنوا بنذر طاهر وجنان.
Many wonder why the Muslim scholars reject Hazrat Ahmad alayhi salam, the promised Messiah, and Imam Mahdi. The answer is quite simple. Apart from arrogance, ignorance, and fear of the people, one of the main reasons is because they await a bloody Messiah and Mahdi, while Allah sent a peaceful one, a peaceful Messiah, a lover of Islam, a lover of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Ahmad alayhi salam stated, "No true Muslim has ever believed that Islam should be spread by the sword. Islam has always been propagated through its inherent qualities. Those who calling themselves Muslims seek to spread Islam by means of the sword are not aware of its inherent qualities, and their conduct resembles the conduct of wild beasts." Let us now hear the world's most famous Muslim scholars speak about what they believe the Latter-day Messiah would do.
The jizya money will not be taken anymore from the Christians or from the Jews. They have no other alternative but to accept Islam.
أَنزِلَ فِيكُمْ Jesus, the son of Mary, will descend upon you, among you, حَكَمًا عَدْلًا, and he will be a just ruler, a just judge. وَيَضَعُ الْجِزْيَةَ No more ransom. It's either Islam or else.
And he will cancel the jizya. Because after the Isa alayhi salam comes, everyone will either be a Muslim, and there will be no other choice. There will be no jizya. You either a believer or that's it.
Prophet Isa alayhi salam will no longer accept the jizya, that tax. That means it's an indication, no other religion than Islam.
And what does that mean? Nothing else but Islam is going to be acceptable.
فالذين يوجدون في ذلك الزمان من أهل الكتاب إما أن يقتل وإما أن يؤمن بعيسى
ويضع الجزية ولا يقبل إلا الإسلام
ويضع الجزية ولا يقبل إلا الإسلام
الجزية بي ختم کر دیں گے کہ آج کے بعد یہ اسلام ہی ہے تلوار
ويضع الجزية جزية کو اٹھا لیں گے یا تو مسلمان یا تلوار فیصلہ کرے گی
وہی آ جائے گا جس کو وہ خدا اور خدا کا بیٹا کہنا ہے وہی کہے گا یار دین یہی برحق ہے تو ان کی پر بھی حجت تمام ہو جائے گی تو ایمان لے آئیں گے سارے جو نہیں لائیں گے وہ قتل ہو جائیں گے
ویضع الجزیہ اور جہاد کو کیا کریں گے بھائی جہاد کریں گے جزیے کے بغیر اما الاسلام و اما السیف یا تو تلوار یا اسلام
لیکن یہ کہ وہ ان کا گریٹر گریو یارڈ بنے گا پھر بالآخر حضرت مسیح ہی زمین پر دوبارہ نازل کیے جائیں گے اور انہی کے ذریعے سے اس قوم کی ہلاکت ہوگی آخری
Just look at how violent the beliefs of the mullahs are. This is one major difference between Ahmadiyyat and their false version of Islam. To have such views after the coming of the Messiah and being corrected by him is complete ignorance. In Sahih Bukhari, the sign he will abolish the jizya is also narrated as the laying aside of religious wars, meaning the Messiah won't fight. How dare this so-called scholar twist the words of our beloved Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? correcting this false view of the so-called scholars of Islam, Hazrat Ahmad alayhis-salam stated, "Further, your doctrines that the Messiah, son of Mary, will descend from heaven, join forces with the Mahdi, and wage war with the people in order to coerce them into becoming Muslims are such as defame the religion of Islam. Where in the Holy Quran is the use of compulsion in religious matters permitted? Rather, Allah the Exalted says in the Quran that there is no compulsion in religion. How then can the Messiah, son of Mary, be granted liberty to coerce people to such an extent that he would force them to either accept Islam or face death without even accepting the jizya?" Hazrat Ahmad alayhis-salam then states, "Recall the hadith from Sahih al-Bukhari which honors the promised Messiah by saying, 'Yada'ul Harb,' that is to say, when the Messiah comes, he will put an end to religious wars. Accordingly, I command those who have joined my ranks to refrain from all such thoughts, to purify their hearts, to foster sympathy, and to be compassionate towards the suffering. They should spread peace on earth, because that will cause their faith to spread in return." We end this video with a poem written by Hazrat Ahmad alayhis salam. It is recited by respected Murtaza Manan Sahib.
Ab chhod do jihad ka, ae dosto khayal, din ke liye haram hai, ab jang aur qital, ab jang aur qital, ab aa gaya masih jo din ka imam hai, ab aa gaya masih jo din ka imam hai, din ke tamam jangon ka ab ikhtitam hai. Kyun chhodte ho logo nabi ki hadis ko, jo chhodta hai chhod do tum us khabees ko. Kyun bhoolte ho tum yada'ul harb ki khabar, kya ye nahi bukhari mein dekho to khol kar, kya ye nahi bukhari mein dekho to khol kar.